Hey everybody, Derek Pierce here, and in this video we're going to be diving into how to know with 100% certainty of what to do with your SEO campaigns. It's going to get your stuff ranked. I'm going to show you exactly how to pull this whole thing off. First, if you're new here, be sure to subscribe to the channel. I release new digital marketing videos every single week. If you like this video, give this a thumbs up, as that helps me get found in the algorithm and allows me to make more videos just like this one that you see here. So with that being said, let's go ahead, let's dive in. I'm going to show you exactly how to know what to do to get your stuff ranked in the search engines. So we all know that top tier SEO professionals are using data, they're using tools to make decisions. They're not just guessing at what keywords to go after, they're not guessing what content to go after. Each piece of content has a purpose. And in order to do that, you've got to be able to see from a 30,000 foot view of exactly what to do next. Now, the thing is different markets, different niches, different keywords all have different requirements. Some are very competitive, some are not so competitive. And so what you want to do is you want to be able to see all of that before you go after the particular keywords that you want to target. And you want to be able to know exactly what you need to create your content around, how many words, what to include on that page as far as headings, as far as images, the whole nine. You want to know what to do first, second, and third, and so on. And you also want to know what type of backlinks that you may be missing once you get your page created. So that's where this tool comes into play. Now, in the previous video, we talked about the free Chrome extension for Surfer, which allows you to find additional keywords. This is the premium version of Surfer, which takes that strategy to the next level. So in the previous video, I give you a 7-step questionnaire, which was who, what, when, where, how, why, and what to do next, and allows you to see everything from a 30,000 foot view before you ever even start your campaigns, which is why I highly recommend this tool at the very beginning when you're starting to build your campaigns out, when you're starting to do your keyword research, so that way you can see what your competition is doing. So there's a lot of different features to Surfer SEO. I'm not going to go over all of these. I'm going to mainly focus on a couple of these. I'll do a separate review video when it comes to Surfer, because this is not really a Surfer SEO. This is more about how to know how to target and how to create the content with Surfer in to gain a competitive advantage in the search results. So you've got content editor. That's one of the things that we're going to be looking at. Then we've also got the SERP analyzer. Okay, so those are the main two features that we are going to be plugging in. So if I go to SERP analyzer, what this allows us to do is this allows us to plug in our keyword right here. So we just put in a keyword search here. You can see that I did this earlier for best adjustable dumbbells. I'm going to click on this. I did that so we wouldn't have to wait, so you could see exactly what we're looking at. So when I click on this particular campaign, I'm able to look and see what number 1 through 10, the top spot, what the word count is. So you can see the average word count is 3,000 words for this particular keyword. So if I was going to go after this particular keyword, guess what? I'm going to be needing to create somewhere in the ballpark of 3,000 words of content. So if I wanted to go down and inspect each one of these a little bit more in more detail, I can do so right here. So you can see right here, this is a New York Times .com article, and you can see there is a content score. This is a built-in content score within SEO Surfer, so it goes between 1 and 100. So that way, you can kind of look at it and say, okay, what's their content missing? Then you've got this right here. This is a domain score from 1 to 10, showing you the authority of the domain. So you can see right here, very authoritative domain. Number 2 here, very authoritative domain right off the bat, because this is New York Times, this is CNET. And you can continue to look at the top 10 to see the content score as well as the domain authority to gauge how competitive this niche or this market is going to be and how authoritative these domains. You can see in the top 10, a lot of these sites are off of very authoritative domains. And what I would do if I was going after this particular keyword and let's say I had already built a piece of content, I would click right here and I would add my website or my URL, and I would compare it to the top 10. And Surfer SEO is then going to in turn give me an entire list of everything that I need to do to be able to rank in the top for that particular keyword. So if we scroll down here, if we had a site in this instance, we could click on to run an audit, which is what I'm going to do here in just a second. We can see right here, this site right here, this is not mine, by the way, but you can see it's ranking number 20, and the domain authority is a 3, content score would be a 58. So what we can do here is we can run an audit. I'm going to click on that, and this is going to give me suggestions on exactly what to do. That's why I said when you're looking at this from a bigger picture and you're able to see exactly the modifications, the adjustments to make, this makes this a no-brainer, and this makes this to where this is not even really competitive anymore, because this is analyzing everything that Google is rewarding, and then you're able to go out and recreate that and outdo your competitors. So you can see you've got missing common backlinks. If this was your site, this would show you the missing common backlinks. You could click right here to show the missing backlinks, and this would show you all the sites that you're missing links from that the top 10 has. Then this true density, this is really an advanced feature. This is really cool because this allows you to review the list of the important terms that your particular pages are missing out on. So you can see right here, adjustable dumbbells. In this case, in this particular page, there is 9 instances of adjustable dumbbells included in this page. The suggestions is 38 to 66. So it's telling us to add anywhere from 29 to 57 of this particular term. Now, if we don't know what to include, guess what? Surfer SEO gives us examples. You can click right here, and this is how this plays out, where you're able to look at what other people and how they have integrated this particular term within their content, so that way there's no question about it. So if you've got a term that you're kind of uncertain of what it is, or what an explanation is, you can see examples of how it's used, and then you can go in and modify that if you wanted to. So I'm going to click hide details, and you can get an idea of what else this particular page is missing. So you can see words, there's no action required. So this says 5,204 words. This falls into the range. The range in this case is 3,999 to 9,443 words of content is what they are suggesting. Then this is saying consider removing 143 to 177 words that have been bolded. So apparently this page has bolded too many keywords or too many words, and have got them in the strong tag or the bold tag, and this is telling you that you need to remove those as it compares to the top 10. Then you can see we needed to add 41 words in a H2 to H6 tag. So this is what top tier professionals, SEO professionals, are armed with, and this is why they're able to outrank their competitors. They're able to see what the competition is. They're able to then create the content knowing exactly what words to include in the content. And then once their page is published, if they need to make modifications, they're able to then analyze their pages versus the top 10, make the suggested modifications, and reap the rewards. So I want to show you something real quick here. You can see all of these other actions that they are suggesting to take. But if we scroll down here, you can see the speed. So the load time, you can see that in this particular case, they are suggesting to reduce the load time. So if we click on show details, this gives us the load time of the top sites and the load time of the particular site that we are auditing. In other words, we're not reinventing the wheel here. We are looking at the footprints. We are looking at what Google is rewarding, and then we are turning around and building that, and we are outdoing what our competitors are doing, and we're focusing on 3 key elements. Number one, we're focusing on the site speed, which is very important. Secondly, we are focusing on our content creation, and then third, we are focusing on the backlinks. If you focus on those 3 things, then you're going to do extremely well with search. Now, one of the things that I want to show you inside the SERP Analyzer that is a massive time saver. Normally, what we would do is when we are inspecting other people's pages that are ranking the top 10, we would want to look at their content. We would want to look and see what they have highlighted as far as their title, their description, as well as their headers. What we can do here is we can go to one of these pages that we want to look at, and we just click this right here and click on content outline. And this gives us a view of all the main ingredients and the main elements of their content. So you can see we've got the URL, we've got the title, we've got the description, and then we've got all of their header tags right here. And then we've got all of the words that they have included in bold. So this is an incredible time saver, so that way we can go out and we know how to create our content chunks, what we can create our content about. Now, I'm not telling you to copy these verbatim or anything like that, but you can look at several of these and you can see how people have laid out their content, and you will know how to structure yours as well. Plus, if you are outsourcing some of the articles, then you can easily come in and create some of these content outlines to hand it off to them, so that way they'll know how to structure their content. Now, in the next portion of Surfer SEO that we're going to be looking at is the content editor. Now, in the previous video, we talked about using the Surfer SEO extension, which give us a small amount of data to go with. This opens up a whole nother world as far as content creation goes. So what I did was I included our keyword in this example. In this case, it's best adjustable dumbbells. We're going to click on this and I'm going to show you what I mean here. So the right hand side, this is where the content score comes in. What we want our content score to be is we want it to be somewhere in the green. It doesn't have to be 100 out of 100, but we want it to get somewhere in the green. And what this is going to do is this is going to give us the number of words that we want to include in our content. Now, remember, I said all niches and all markets are different. Keywords are different. Some of these are going to be more competitive than others. Some of them, you're going to see what the top 10, the suggested words are like 800 words, especially with some of the local markets that you may be going after. But this gives us an idea of what to include. So you can see we've already got 9 words here. What this is going to do is it's going to suggest the recommended range. So in this case, they're saying 3,799 words to 4,368. This is including how many paragraphs that we need to have. We need to have at least 73 paragraphs, how many headings to include, and then this is also including how many images we need to include. So this is why I say Surfer SEO is telling you exactly how to create the content and what to create the content about, and then it takes it to a whole nother level, as you're fixing to see here. This gives us the words to include and the range of times to include them. So you can see right here, best adjustable dumbbells is showing that we've already used this one time because this is the title. This is the title that we use with our term. But you can see the suggestion is to use this 18 to 43 times inside of our content. Then you've got adjustable dumbbells. This is showing us to use anywhere from 52 to 71 times. And as we type in this content here, this right-hand side will tell us the word count that we have got of those terms. So let me just go through and show you an example here. So in this case, if I was typing this out on the fly, I would say, so you're interested in finding the best adjustable dumbbells for working out. If so, you're in the right spot. Okay, so you can see right here, this changed from having 9 words, now we've got 22. You can see now, instead of having best adjustable dumbbells one time, now this is showing that we've got this used as 2 times. Adjustable dumbbells, now we've got this twice. Best adjustable, this is used twice. And this will continue to auto-populate. Once we continue to create this content, this will populate the number of words and the number of suggestions that we need to include. This will all change. This also gives us a sample headings for our headers that you can see right here. And this is how Surfer SEO works. And this helps you as it relates to knowing what to create your content about, as well as formulating and structuring your content so that way you can get the number of words and you can get your content plugged in the right way and what to include in the content. So that way it's no more guesswork. You're not just staring at a blank screen, wondering what to type, or if you're typing out something, wondering that this is just going to be another piece of content that goes nowhere. You're going to know exactly what to do, how to include it. And in the next video that I'm going to be showing you, I'm going to show you how to get this content practically written for you. Literally, this is artificial intelligence at its finest. So for those of you that are watching this, if you're not a member of Surfer SEO, I recommend it, highly recommend it. I want you to click in the link inside the description if you're here on YouTube to sign up for this. This is a game changer as it relates to knowing how to structure your content and knowing what to look for when it comes to competitive analysis for your keywords. So thanks for being here. If you're new here to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I release new digital marketing videos, and I would love to see you here. And I'll see you in the next video where we talk about having this content created practically for you. See you then.